I think Peter Costello is deluding himself that he thought that he would have won the election. He never had the numbers within his party, and he definitely hasn't had the numbers within the wider electorate amongst the popular vote in Australia.
Peter Costello is deluding himself when he says that he would have won the last election. It is a tough move coming from Treasurer to be Prime Minister, because you sort of always have that stigma attached that you're the money man and you're sort of the serious guy, and you can't have certainly the morning breakfast show appeal of a Kevin Rudd.
I agree with Peter Costello's comments that the Coalition bungled the Republic, Reconciliation and Pauline Hanson. I think Kevin Rudd's government showed that it's quite easy to take that step and go down the path of reconciliation. I don't see any reason why the Coalition couldn't have done that when it was in power.
I think there are elements of weakness in his decision, and also not actually challenging and standing up and saying, look, you know, I can take the party forward and I can move on to a new era. Just waiting for the leadership to be handed on a silver platter didn't show strength to the public.
If Peter Costello chooses to stay in Parliament, I don't think he's destabilising the leadership at all. I think as of next week, when this story disappears, he's yesterday's news, he's yesterday's man, and Peter Costello will be gone to the history pages of Australian politics.
Yeah, but whilst Costello's in the game still, then you know, you're not going to see a challenge from some of the other prominent.
But I think back, what he's saying now is that he's gone, he's stepping out, he's just biding his time until he gets offered a position on a few boards.
Because he's been involved in politics for so long, he could have a lot to offer to the party in terms of rebuild and advice. But I think if the media starts to portray that as a bit of a two-man war kind of thing, then maybe it'll destabilise the party.
Malcolm Turnbull's on holidays overseas at the moment. He's sipping on pina coladas by the pool, just counting his chickens, and he's a happy man. If he doesn't make a leadership bid in the next fortnight of Parliament sitting, then the one after that in October, he definitely will.
Jeanette Howard might have had a big influence on how long John Howard stayed in power. I think she would have been the type of lady who would have fancied hosting the bushes.
I'm sure she's played a role in many issues that we don't actually fully understand.
No touching on that resistance soil!
I don't think I'll pay $55 to read Peter Costello's memoirs.
I'm really interested to read Peter Costello's memoirs. I'll be shelling out the $55. I really want to find out about those young Liberal years.
It's going in the library,
the Vice President, I think it was Vice President, maybe the Victorian Executive or something like that. That sounds like a hell of a lot of fun to me, and I want to find out all about it.
Maybe I can borrow your copy instead of having to wait to
dance. Yeah, good. Well, I'll just borrow yours then.